Recently, a self-proclaimed prophet in Ghana made a shocking prophecy that certain prominent political and religious leaders in Ghana are going to die the year 2019 if prayers are not said. The question is, does God communicate messages of doom? How does God speak with his prophets? Do prophets even exist in our time? And how do we differentiate between a true and a false prophet? Now let's find out what the Bible says. For false messiahs and false prophets would appear and perform great signs and wonders to deceive, if possible, even the elect. The fact that false prophets would abound in the last days also means good prophets would be there. God always communicates through prophets. In fact, the Bible in Amos chapter 3 verse 7 makes us understand that it is through prophets that God reveals his plans for the future. It says, "Surely the Lord God does nothing unless he reveals his secret to his servant, the prophet." That is why God admonishes us to believe in his prophet. 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 20, the Bible says, "And they arose early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, 'Hear me, O Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem. Believe in the Lord your God, so ye shall be established. Believe his prophet, so ye shall prosper.'" So when we believe in God's prophet, we become prosperous, because when we believe in God's prophet, we are actually believing and accepting the very word of God. Now, before we continue, I want to share with you four important points that you must note concerning the gift of prophecy. Number one, prophecy does not come from human inspiration, but from God. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 21, the Bible says, "For prophecy never came by the will of men. Holy men of God spoke as they were moved by the Holy Spirit." So human beings cannot manufacture prophecy. If anyone tells you that, "Come, let me prophesy in your life," it is obvious that it is not coming from God. Number two, not all prophets are Bible authors. In fact, there are many prophets in the Bible, but not all of them took part in the writing of the Bible. A very good example is John the Baptist. He was a prophet, but he did not write any book of the Bible. Number three, in the last days, God will speak through prophets. Joel chapter 2, verses 28 to 31, the Bible says that, "I will pour out my spirit on all flesh. Your sons and daughters would prophesy." And finally, the fourth point I want you to note is that God did not appoint everybody to be a prophet. Ephesians chapter 4, reading from verses 7, verses 8, and verses 11, makes us understand that he gave some apostles, some prophets, and some evangelists, some pastors, and some teachers. So friends, it is not everybody who has been called to be a prophet. Now before we continue, there are three important things that the Bible commands us regarding the gift of prophecy in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 20 to 21. The first one is, we must not despise prophecy. If anyone gives you a prophetic message, don't despise it. But the second point you must note is that you must prove all things. Prove them according to what the Bible has said concerning the message that you have received. And finally, you must hold fast to that which is good. So never condemn any prophetic message. Prove them first, and then if it is good, you hold it. But the question is, how does God speak to his prophet? This is very important in helping us to identify the genuine prophet and the fake prophet. The Bible in Numbers chapter 12, verses 6 to 8 says that, "He said, 'Hear now my words. If there is a prophet among you, I, the Lord, shall make myself known to him in a vision. I shall speak with him in a dream. With him I speak mouth to mouth, even openly, not in dark saying, and he behold the form of the Lord. Why then were you not afraid to speak against my servant, against Moses?'" So friends, there are three ways that God communicates with his prophets according to Numbers chapter 12. The first one is through dreams, and then secondly, through visions, and then the final one is through mouth to mouth, that is one-on-one encounter. That is how God communicates with his prophets. Now with that in mind, I want to share with you eight important tests of a true prophet. Number one, the true prophet's message would always be in agreement with the Bible. You see, what this means is that what a prophet claims to have received from God must be in perfect harmony with the rest of God's word, because God does not contradict himself. The Bible says in Psalm 15 verse 4 that God does not change his mind. Again, Malachi chapter 3 verse 6 also says that God is the same. He doesn't change. And so what he has said in his word, whenever another message comes, it must be in total conformity with the word of God. Now, one important test that will guide you into differentiating between a false prophet and a genuine prophet of God is Isaiah chapter 8 verse 20. It says, "To the law and to the testimony, if they do not speak according to this word, it is because they have no light in them." When they speak any word that is different from the word of God, it means they are not from God. Number two, the message of a genuine prophet must be fulfilled exactly. You see, friend, the proof of a true prophet lies in part in the fulfillment of his or her prediction. But there is one thing I want you to understand about the fulfillment of the prophetic message. When it comes to prophecy, we have two forms. We have conditional prophecies, and then we have unconditional prophecies. If the message is conditional, it means its fulfillment is dependent on the actions of the people whom the message is meant for. But if it is unconditional, then it means there is absolutely nothing that you can do to change what has been said. Now, the Bible in Jeremiah chapter 28 verse 9 says that the prophet which prophesies of peace, when the word of the prophet shall come to pass, then shall the prophet be known that the Lord has truly sent him. And so all his predictions must all come to pass if it is not a conditional prophecy. Now, Deuteronomy chapter 18 verses 21 to 22 says something very, very important. Now, I want you to take note of this text. It says, "And if thou say in thy heart, how shall we know the word which the Lord has not spoken? When a prophet speaketh in the name of the Lord, if the thing follow not, nor come to pass, this is the thing which the Lord has not spoken. But the prophet has spoken it presumptuously, thou shalt not be afraid of him." Friend, this is pretty straightforward. If a prophecy comes and it is not fulfilled accordingly, then that prophecy did not come from God. And so in other words, if a prediction that a prophet makes does not come to pass, he is a false prophet. But if the prediction is a conditional prophecy, then that condition must be fulfilled. If it is not fulfilled, then it will come to pass. That is how it is. A very good example is the prophecy that God gave to Jonah to the people of Nineveh. When the people fulfilled the condition that was to repent of their ways, that prophecy that God was going to destroy Nineveh did not come to pass. Number three, prophecy is not man-made. You see, a genuine prophet would only prophesy when he is moved by the Spirit of God, not on his own. That is what the Bible says in 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 21. It says, "For prophecy never came by the will of man, but holy men of God spoke as they were moved by the Holy Spirit." That is why I said earlier on that if anyone calls you and tells you to come so that he can prophesy in your life, that is not from God. Because we cannot determine when God wants to speak to his children. We cannot force God to speak when God is not ready to deliver any message. We must understand that a prophet is just a mouthpiece of God. You only speak when the Spirit of God has a message to be delivered to the people of God. Number four, a genuine prophet does not give his own interpretation to prophecy. When a prophetic message is given to a prophet of God, he only waits for the interpretation or the meaning of the message, or would look for the meaning of that prophetic message in the word of God. In 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 20, it says, "But know this first of all, that no prophecy of the scripture is a matter of one's own interpretation." Number five, a genuine prophet would always point out the sins of people against God. That is what the Bible says in Isaiah chapter 51 verse 1. It says, "Cry loudly, do not hold back, raise your voice like a trumpet, and declare to my people their transgression, and to the house of Jacob their sin." Anyone who claims to be a prophet, yet condone to sin, and keeps quiet when there is immorality, when there is transgression in the house of God, then there is a problem with that man who claims to be a prophet of God. Number six, now this is very important. A genuine prophet prophesies to edify, to exhort, to comfort in religious matters. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 3, the Bible says, "But one who prophesies speaks to men for edification and exhortation and consolation." In other words, a true prophet gives direction to God's true church, and a true prophet's message would cover all these three areas. That is edification, which means to instruct morally, exhortation, that is to strongly advise, and then finally to comfort, that is to soothe in distress or sorrow or to console. All these three things would be exemplified by a true prophet. But unfortunately, what do we see in the world today? We see people who claim to be prophet of God only prophesying message of doom. People actually prophesy that I saw there is going to be an accident where you will die. These are all messages of doom, which God's prophets do not prophesy such things. We must be careful of such messages. Number 7, a genuine prophet would always recognize the incarnation or the deity of Jesus Christ. The Bible in 1 John chapter 4, reading from verses 1 to 3, says this, "Beloved, do not believe every spirit, but test the spirit to see whether they are from God, because many false prophets have gone out into the world. By this you know the spirit of God. Every spirit that confesses that Jesus Christ has come in the flesh is from God, and every spirit that does not confess Jesus is not from God. This is the spirit of the Antichrist, which you have heard that it is coming, and now it is already in the world." Beloved friend, this test is broader than simply believing that Jesus Christ became a human being. It includes everything the Bible teaches about Jesus Christ. He became man in order to live a sinless life and then to die for the sinful humanity. He became man so that after his resurrection and ascension, he could minister to us in the heavenly sanctuary. Number 8, a genuine prophet works and lives in harmony with the Bible. Listen to what Jesus Christ said about this particular test in Matthew chapter 7, verse 20. He says, "So then, you will know them by their fruit." You see, beloved friend, the only way you can identify a tree which you are not aware of is by the fruit that the tree bears. So the life of the prophet, that is the fruit that he or she bears, will tell you if he or she is from God or not from God. Friend, the context of this statement is Jesus' warning to the disciples to beware of false prophets. Jesus Christ applied to the principle that a good tree always bears good fruit. In the same way, a genuine prophet who is from God would always bear good fruit according to what is written in Galatians chapter 5. You see, this does not mean that a prophet would be perfect all the time. No, prophets are also human beings. They fall once in a while. But God's prophets have always had fruit, and that fruit would always be the fruit that is in conformity with what the Bible says. And so even though a prophet is a human being and may fall occasionally, their life must always be consistent with what the Bible has said. So, beloved friend, now that you know these 8 important tests of a genuine prophet, I want you to apply them to those people who claim to be prophets that you know. What kind of fruit do they bring forth? What influence do their teachings have on other people? Look at what is happening in the world. People who claim to be prophets of God, yet we see them on television only preaching about riches, about doom, about things that is not consistent with the word of God. But this is exactly what Jesus Christ prophesied that it will happen in the last days, that in the last days, false prophets would abound. Now, friend, one important thing I want you to understand is that a church without the spirit of prophecy is blind. This is exactly what the Bible said in Matthew chapter 15, verse 14. It says, "Let them alone. They are blind guides of the blind. And if a blind man guides a blind man, both will fall into a pit." So the gift of prophecy is very, very important in our days. That is why the enemy has sent out his men who claim to be the mouthpiece of God. Now you know how to test a true prophet. Use this test so that you will not be deceived. Another important thing I want to touch on is that miracles do not prove that a person is from God. You see, I mentioned 8 tests and I didn't talk about miracles, because the fact that a person can perform miracle does not mean he or she is from God. Now listen to what the Bible says in Revelation chapter 16, verse 14. It says, "For they are the spirit of demons, performing signs, which go out to the kings of the world to gather them together for the war of the great day of God Almighty." So anybody can perform miracles. In fact, the devil in these last days will use miracle as a tool to deceive people. And unfortunately today, many people follow these prophets because of the miracles they perform. Most of them are actually fake. They hire actors to perform for them so that they can deceive you to believe that they are genuine. Be very careful that you do not fall to this last day's deceptive tricks of the enemy. But beloved friend, when we believe in God's true prophet, the Bible in 2 Chronicles chapter 20 verse 20 says that God will prosper us. So now you know the truth. Do not allow miracles or the fact that the person has a lot of followers. Believe in Jesus Christ. Follow Jesus Christ. He has given us a lot of messages, messages of hope, messages of deliverance, messages of salvation in His Word. Do not allow men who claim to be prophets to deceive you with their deceptive messages. Every time, make sure you test the prophetic message, and then when you test it and it is true, hold fast to it. But if it is not true, disregard it with no fear. Don't let anyone deceive you. Remember, Jesus is coming again very soon, and when He comes, only those who live their lives according to what has been written in the Word of God, not according to what was said by your prophet, by your bishop, by your pastor, but only those who live their lives according to what the Bible has said would be saved. Today is a fine opportunity to give your life to Jesus Christ so that He can write your name in His book of life. May God bless you, and may He grant you the strength to live a life of purity till He comes again. In Jesus' name, Amen. We have come with all